you all are doing good. In today's video, we are going to see in the chapter factorization. Factorize 4x squared plus 8x plus 3. See, the given expression is in the form of a x squared plus b x plus c. Okay. So, ax square plus bx plus c, the form of expression given in the type of ax square plus bx plus c, that is a is what? 4 and b is 8 and c equal to 3, that is a is the coefficient of x squared and b is the coefficient of x and c is the constant. Do you understand? That is ax squared plus bx plus c. Here they are given as 4x squared plus 8x plus 3. See, we have to calculate the factors by first of all we have to find out this a into c, that is we have to find out a into c. Okay. And after that, we have to split the factors what we find out for this AC. So, what we will get like 12 or 15 or something else, right? So, we have to split the factors of AC such that the sum should be equal to the coefficient of X. Do you understand what I am saying? See, we have to multiply the coefficient of x squared into constant term. We have to multiply this a and c. So, you will get ac is equal to some value here. And then you have to find out the factors for ac in such the way, if you add the factors, you will get the coefficient of x, that is b. You have to get the value of b when you add the factors. Okay, so let us find out. See, 4 is what? A, and b is what? 8, and c is 3, right? So we have to find out a into c. So ac is equal to what? 12, and coefficient of x is b, that is b is the coefficient of x. So, here b is 8. So, we have to find out two factors. If we multiply the two numbers, we have to get the answer 12. And if we add the factors, we should get the answer as 8. Now, we understand, I think. So, what are the possibilities to find the product of as 12. So, if I want 12, I can choose two integers a and b in such a way a can be 4 and b can be 3. Then I will get, if I multiply, I will get 12. Otherwise, if I choose a as 6 and b as 12, 2, I will get again 12, or else 1 multiplied by 12, a as 1 and b I take 12, again I will get 12. But here we have to see ac equal to 12, but a plus b, ab equal to 12 and a plus b should be equal to what? 8. So if I choose this a as 4 and b as 3, I will get ab 12, but will I get a plus b equal to 8? No. I will get a plus b equal to 7. Right? Because 4 plus 3 is 7 only. I will get. But I need what? A plus b equal to 8. And if I multiply these two factors, I have to get 12. Right? So, 4 into 3, 12, I cannot take. So, I can choose 6 into 2. If I add 6 plus 2, I will get 8, and if I multiply 6 into 2, I will get 12. Okay, So like this you have to choose the integers a and b. Okay children, so now this 4x squared plus 8x plus 3, I can write this as 4x squared plus a and b is what, 6 and 2, right? So I can split this 8x as 6x plus 2x, right? So then only you'll get 8x plus the constant of 3. Just we are putting this factors, whatever we have chose, we have to write in between as the coefficient of x term. So we have to split the term AC into 2, right? 6, 2. So we are multiplied 4 into 3, 12. So we are writing the factors 6 and 2 as 2 terms. Okay. So now 4x squared plus 8x plus 3 equal to 4x squared plus 6x plus 2x plus 3. Okay children. So in this I can choose these two terms. First I'll take these two and I'll take out the common factors. So 4 and for 6 I can choose 2. I can take outside the 2 and x is in both the terms. So I am taking out this 2x and I can write this as 2x. The remaining term will be in 4x squared is 2x. And if I take out 2x, only 3 will be remaining here, because 2x into 2x I will get this 4x squared, and 2x into 3 if I multiply I will get the 6x. Okay, so plus here I can write, there is no common term, so I can write this as plus 1 plus 2x plus 3. So I will get both the terms, 2x plus 3 are in both the terms. So I can take this out and I write this as 2x plus 3 for both the common term. 2x plus 3 I can take out as one factor, and I can add this 2x and plus 1 as another factor. Do you understand, children? See, this is very easy if you understand well. Then only you can do all the problems in the chapter. Okay, so first we have to multiply the coefficient of x squared and the constant term, right? And after that you have to see the factors. You have to find out any two factors by taking different possibilities. You will take any two factors, and if the factors are added, you have to get the middle term, that is coefficient of x, you must get. Okay, by doing the problems only you will understand well. Just by watching or doing only one problem you cannot understand. If you are doing it regularly, then you will be very easy to calculate these problems. I think understand clearly. We'll meet it in a next session. Take care.